Hey, it's Becca. Ooh, I am so psyched to pick up where we left off with segment one of this two-part video. I'm talking about an article from the Vault of Erowid about cannabis as a spirit plant. If you didn't see part one, I'll give you a link here so that you can get up to speed on that. And in short, you'll find on the Erowid website an abandoned article, an interview from 1989 about marijuana's ability to raise consciousness. But because it was the height of the war on drugs back then, that article was axed by the magazine that had assigned it. So let's look at some of the jaw-dropping comments made by the man who was interviewed for the article. By the way, the names of both the man who was interviewed and the reporter who interviewed him have been kept anonymous over all these years. The man was described by the reporter as a well-dressed gentleman. He stepped up to be interviewed after the reporter was refused entry to a public gathering in Berkeley, California. The purpose of the gathering was to, quote, "brainstorm the ways and means to sustain a fundamental shift of social consciousness away from cultural materialism and toward spiritual unfoldment," end quote. But even with that noble purpose, the organizers of the gathering had decided that the group discussion would be closed to the public. So it was this man, who the reporter simply referred to as Blake, stepped up to be interviewed as kind of a consolation. He was an organizing member of a little-known meditation group called the World Mind Society, which actually has a website that you can look at. So Blake started out the interview by saying, I quote, "We at WMS, World Mind Society, believe in the higher potentials of human consciousness and its power to transform the self and the world. Our approach is to make the best use of the tools that are already available to the human being for the purpose of self-empowerment. Among these are the human body and mind, individual meditation, the sacramental use of marijuana, and the use of group meditation, or in other words, group mind force." When prodded by the reporter to say more about marijuana, Blake continues, quote, "Marijuana can be a powerful tool for self-improvement if used with the proper focus. This plant has the potential for use as a psychoactive booster of consciousness. It is a kind of psychic vitamin that can expand one's abilities mentally, psychically, and spiritually," end quote. Marijuana as a psychic vitamin. I like that. And actually, in my experience in working with the plant, she certainly has proved herself to be a booster of exploring the deep inner reaches of consciousness. But he says, the way our society uses cannabis doesn't even begin to scratch the surface of this. Quote, "When people smoke, their intention is usually focused just on feeling a little better or upon using the smoke as an avenue for interaction with others. So instead of realizing they have just undergone an important and powerful shift of consciousness, they waste what he's calling a glorious opportunity. They fritter away a wonderful means to gain greater inner strength by focusing upon trivial things." But, and get this, he says, "Marijuana is such an excellent tool for seeking higher consciousness that even with a minimum of knowledge, the novice smoker can begin an exciting spiritual journey," end quote. Okay, I just want to put in a little plug here. This is why I guide cannabis ceremonies, to unlock our potential and what they didn't know back then to help heal troubling emotions. Yes. So I invite you to subscribe here and move on over to my website, canonaut.com, to sign up so that we can be in touch. And one final thing in this interview that was kept on the DL all these years, here comes the clincher. Blake says, quote, "I think it's safe to say that the government and corporate world has a vested interest in maintaining the public consciousness within predictable limits. They fear the possible impact of marijuana's use on the mind. When it is properly used, it expands consciousness," he says. "In other words, it accelerates personal enlightenment," end quote. The reporter adds, and enlightened people aren't interested in $500 suits or $5 million houses. They know that there is more to life than this, yes? Yes. And I'll leave you with this quote from the mysterious Blake. Believing that marijuana is just a toy is like treating the space shuttle as just another 4th of July bottle rocket. We must all use it once again as the tool for the expansion of consciousness that it is intended to be. End quote. Powerful words for a powerful spirit plant. I'm Becca, and I'm here for you and with you.